Assalamualaikum and a very good day to all my panels, technologists Dr. Al-Amin bin Mohamad Sultan, Insinyur Dr. Mohamad Remy bin Anang Masuri, and Encik Nur Akramin bin Mohamad. I am Fatin Nur Anisah binti Nur Hasni from STE4 BMFG, proudly presenting to you my FYP1 project entitled An Assessment of Manufacturing Sector on Economic Growth in Selected Manufacturing Process Industries in Melaka under Supervised Associate Professor Insinyur Dr. Mohamad bin Minhat. First, I will introduce to you about overall project including problem statement, objective and project scope. Early 2020, an unidentified virus was reported in Wuhan province, China. Sudden increase in death toll and infection rate within human-to-human interaction causes a panic within people. Make it worse, Malaysia just received thousands of tourists in late January due to a celebration. An action was taken by the government to announcing a lockdown to flatten the curve and decreasing the death toll within people. Causes, economic activity are all being halved, including import and export trade. As a result, a decrease in gross domestic product rate, GDP, and unbalance in law of supply and demand among Malaysian citizens. From the situation listed, here is the problem statement. First, lockdown turning off all economic sectors, including manufacturing sector, to fully operate. Second, by doing import restriction means supply of raw materials is limited to be processed into a finished goods, thus cannot fulfill market demand. And third, most startup business tend to cut off worker payments and worker layoff and no cash reserve lead to a business shutdown. Next, the objectives that I want to achieve from this project are, first, to study the economic impact of COVID-19 pandemic to manufacturing sectors and methods used by the company to keep production in cycle. Second, to analyze the loss in economic growth of manufacturing sectors and strategy used by the company to overcome with over demand and limited supply with limited human labor. And third, to propose analysis result and finding in which method is the best for the company to use and avoid using cash reserve during pandemic crisis. For my project scope, it will be study the impact of economic growth in manufacturing sector in Melaka from year 2020 to 2021 across COVID-19 pandemic. To understand more about our project, first, we will study the result and discussion from previous research related to our topic. Second, we will study the law of supply and demand, which is the victim that contribute to the economy system. Third, we will study some of the manufacturing sector that will be involved in this project study. Based on Roy 2020, it is said that the pandemic created a severe economic impact in different sectors of the economy, negatively affecting global trade, interest rates, financial market liquidity, and creating sudden demand and supply shocks. From paper and assessment, it can be concluded that pandemic COVID-19 really gave a bad impact in the economy, which is first, production rate almost fall to zero, second, total of worker layoff increase, and third, rise in international trade costs due to border closures by 25%. From Islam and Wii, they conclude that global economy badly affected with each other as limitation in trade markets in first half 2020, which resulted in pandemic badly affected GDP growth, supply chain, and international business and investment. The first economy system introduced is a traditional system, where here people exchange their goods between two or more people within and only an agreement. But as decade passes, this system, which also known as a barter system, is hardly to achieve an agreement. So it is improved to a common system where product is going public and generate economic activity by the centralized government. But then improved to a market system, which is also known as a free market economy, where entrepreneurs manage their own budget and supply by producing according to current demand. But nowadays, we are living in a mixed system, which is a combination of three systems, traditional, command and market system, because the customer's needs and priority tend to vary to achieve the standard living. Next, law of supply and demand. Here, we can see the equilibrium graph of supply and demand which relate to production quantity Y and market price PL. There are four scenarios in law of supply and demand which is varied in every situation. I will show you in the next slide. First, increase in supply. You can see here the graph is slightly shift to the right side from SRAS1 to SRAS2, resulting in increase in production quantity but decrease in market price. This is because when the supply is too many, supplier increase their production rate to increase their profit. But when the supply is too many, the supplier need to finish it before the resources is getting effect. Second, decrease in supply. Graph, we can see here graph shift to the left side from SRAS1 to SRAS2, resulting in decrease in production quantity but increase in market price. This is because supplier is limiting their resources or run out of resources due to certain situation. But this situation can relate to the COVID-19 pandemic in Malaysia in early 2020. Third, decrease in demand. Here we can see the graph is shifted to the upper side from 81 to 82, which is resulting in increase in production quantity and increase in market price. This is because customer purchase power increase due to some reason, which is one, lower interest rate causes more money to be spent by the customer. Second, when it comes to the seasonal celebration, customers tend to buy goods and foods for the celebration itself. And third, product trend. This is usually for the new product. And four, when the customer want to achieve the standard of living. So they tend to buy anything that they want to achieve what they are desired for. And lastly, decrease in demand. From the Keynesian view, we can see the graph is shifted to the downside from 81 to 82, resulting decrease in production quantity and decrease in market price. This is because customer does not want to purchase anything for due to some reason. First, high interest rate causes no more money or limited money to be spent. Second, customer already achieved their desired of living. And third, product does not follow the trend anymore. Next, moving on to some of manufacturing sector that we will study in this project. First, food and beverages. Second, petroleum, coals, chemicals, plastic and rubber. Third, electrical equipment, appliances and components. Fourth, component and electronics. And lastly, transportation. But how I want to know what kind of data is needed for my project and how do I retrieve my data for the analysis? I will discuss it in chapter 3, methodology. First, I retrieve a statistic report from the official page such as PSM, Data of Statistics Malaysia and Matric. This is to analyze Malaysia trade activity from 2020 to 2021. Second, I need to know what is import and export products and market that Malaysia frequently export and import. And third, I need to know the industries that highly frequent in import and export industries in Malaysia, such as electric and electronic, petroleum, food and beverages. Second, I retrieve an annual report from the selected manufacturing sectors such as Petronas, Petron, Nestle and other manufacturing sectors depending on the situation, because originally my project need me to do an analysis for the manufacturing sectors processes in Melaka, but somehow due to sudden increase in case reported and death toll and now a lockdown, my supervisor advised me to do an analysis including all manufacturing sectors around Malaysia and not focusing only in Melaka. For my FYP 2 journey, once I receive the data and classify it, I will make an observation on how companies sustain their business during pandemic and propose an efficient technique to maintain company's production so I can achieve my objective listed. That's all from me and thank you for your time listening to my project presentation. I hope my explanation is very clear and you understand about my project. If there are any advice for improvement for my project presentation or project report, I am honored to receive it and advice for improvement. Thank you and I hope you are having an amazing day ahead.